I'm Phillipe Cagan, and this is my senior memoir. I'll start off by saying that I believe that life's best moments are when you live more in them and aren't concerned as much with pictures. From my childhood up to now, at the age of 17, I can finally say and believe it when I say it, that I have gotten a lot out of life. I haven't always been able to admit this, but now I can be truthful when I say that everything has happened for a reason. My road to becoming the successful version of what I am today hasn't been very easy, but I am proud to say that it has been hard. The lessons I've learned and the tough situations that I have managed to put myself in, intentionally or unintentionally, have been for the best. The adversity in my life and the hard work that I have put in so far has built a sense of pride for me, and it is something I can use and build on for my future success. I know that the road to success is going to be hard, but the question for me is not about if it will happen, rather it's all about when it will happen. I know that I'm going to be great someday. Everything that I have been fortunate enough to do and accomplish in my life would not be possible without my family and friends that have shaped my life in ways that I couldn't even tell them and thank them for. Words can do no justice for what these amazing people have done for me. Something that could be very telling about me is that I have been dependent on my mother for all of my high school years to wake me up in the morning before school, because not even 4 alarm clocks sounding at once would get me out of bed. Things like that, coming especially from my family and also in similar ways from my friends, is a debt that I can never pay back, and it is a reason why I'm so thankful for all of them. I think that life's purpose is to experience failure and realize that working hard is the only way to make your life meaningful. The purpose to me has always been something in life that values pain very highly because it is our best teacher. As far as my hobbies go, I'm a pretty average kid that just likes to hang out with friends and do random stuff, but aside from that, I really like basketball. My dedication to this sport is what has taught me about work ethic. It is something that I will carry with me for the rest of my life. Basketball taught me about the beauty of pain. It taught me to be happy with getting 4 hours of sleep because that meant I could make it to my daily 5 a.m. workouts. And most importantly, it taught me that nothing worth having comes for free. The accomplishment I'm most proud of happening this year was the discovery of my passion to write. I am a big fan of guys like Eric Thomas and Les Brown, who are pretty big motivational speakers and writers, which I look up to. This is an example of their brilliant work.
Walks out into the water, watch this. When he walks out into the water, it goes waist deep. So he's like, this guy. his mouth, my man, like, I'm about to go back in here. This God is mine. But the old man said, I thought you said you wanted to be successful. He said, I do. He said, walk a little further. He came, dropped his head in, held him down, hold him down. My man didn't scratch it, hold him down. I got you. I know you brushed it out, but I got you. He had him held down. I need you for an illustration. He had him held down just before my man was about to pass out. He raised him up. He said, I got a question for you. Somebody answer the question for me. He said, when you were underwater, what did you want to do? Lee, I'm looking for a different word, brother. Man. What's that word? He said, I wanted to breathe. He told the guy, he said, when you want to succeed as bad as you want to breathe, then you'll be successful. I don't know how many of y'all got asthma here today, but if you ever had an asthma attack before, you short of breath, SOB, shortness of breath, you wheezing. The only thing you're trying to do is get some air.
Because of the energy and passion that those kind of speeches have, that's what interests me. As far as being a speaker, speaking to crowds may not be in the plans for me as of now, but what I want to do is exercise my own passion for that kind of writing and that kind of speaking in the form of writing, which is the best way I know how. After high school, I planned on going to MiraCosta College for 2 years before I transferred to a four-year university, which I'm not entirely sure about yet as far as which one and where. If writing doesn't work out for me, I plan on majoring in business administration. My favorite book that I read in high school was 11 Rings by Phil Jackson. This was my favorite book because I am a Lakers fan and because Phil Jackson was a legend of a coach who brought 6 championships to the Chicago Bulls and 5 championships to the Los Angeles Lakers. Phil Jackson's mindset and his appreciation for the process, for hard work, and in discipline is why 11 Rings is my favorite book. As far as what my future holds, I would be lying if I told you that I had a plan. Not saying I don't have situations in mind, because I do, but I expect my life to truly be a roller coaster, and for the thrill and unpredictability to be the best part.